स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ महेश बी कोट एंड आई वेलकम यू टू माई चैनल कलरफुल केमिस्ट्री एंड मीनिंगफुल मैथमेटिक्स। एज यू नो गाइज, वी हैव स्टार्टेड ऑलरेडी न्यू चैप्टर केमिस्ट्री चैप्टर एल्डिहाइड्स कीटोन्स एंड कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड। इन दैट वी हैव स्टार्टेड ऑलरेडी टू पार्ट्स। इन फर्स्ट पार्ट नॉमिनक्लेचर ऑफ एल्डिहाइड्स एंड कीटोन्स एंड इन सेकेंड पार्ट प्रिपरेशन ऑफ सम एल्डिहाइड्स एंड कीटोन्स। सो इन टूडेज क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ एरोमेटिक एल्डिहाइड्स एंड कीटोन्स एज वेल एज physical properties of aldehydes and ketones. So let us begin with that. Preparation of aromatic aldehydes and ketones. So mainly involves several methods. So in that we are going to discuss some 5 to 6 methods. Okay. First method is from toluene. Okay. From toluene. Again, 4 methods are there. In that, first one is Itard's reaction. So, what is Itard's reaction means? When the toluene, on treating with chromyl chloride in the presence of carbon disulfide, chromyl complex is formed, which on acid hydrolysis yield benzaldehyde. So this reaction is called as Itard's reaction. So what is that? When this toluene is treated with chromyl chloride in presence of carbon disulfide gives chromyl complex, which on acid hydrolysis yields benzaldehyde. Okay, so chromyl chloride is there in presence of this one carbon disulfide, and which on acid hydrolysis yield benzaldehyde. So this is what regarding Itard's reaction. This reaction is called as a Itard's reaction. So how this is happening? Let us take a toluene. This is toluene, what we can call. So when we treated this to chromyl chloride, CrO2Cl2, in presence of carbon disulfide, so what is formed? Chromyl complex is formed. Which complex? Chromyl complex is formed. So what is that chromyl complex means? OCrO Cl2H twice. So this is our chromyl complex, which on acid hydrolysis yield benzaldehyde. CHO means this is our benzaldehyde. So this is chromyl complex. This is chromyl chloride. This is toluene. Yes, toluene on treatment with chromyl chloride in presence of carbon disulfide gives chromyl complex, which on acid hydrolysis gives benzaldehyde. So this process is called Itard's reaction. So carefully see here, guys. So in final product we are getting benzaldehyde. Benzene is there now, therefore this is aromatic aldehyde. So this is a first method from toluene. That is nothing but Itard's reaction. Okay, now we'll switch on to the second method. When toluene
on treating with chromic oxide in presence of acetic anhydride gives benzaldehyde derivative. Benzaldehyde acetate derivative, which on acid hydrolysis yields benzaldehyde. Here also we are getting benzaldehyde. So in this method, what we are doing? Tolling on treating with chromic oxide. What is the formula for chromic oxide, guys? CrO3 is a formula for chromic oxide, which on in presence of acetic anhydride, CH3CO twice O, that is a formula for acetic anhydride, gives benzaldehyde acetate derivative. So that derivative I will show here whenever we are writing the reaction. So benzaldehyde derivative, which on acid hydrolysis yield benzaldehyde. So this is the second method for the preparation of aromatic aldehyde. So let us see what this exactly. So let us take a toluene. This is toluene. Toluene on treatment with CrO3, that is chromic oxide and acetic anhydride, CH3CO twice O. This is called acetic anhydride. Gives benzaldehyde derivative. What is that? Benzaldehyde derivative means CH3CO, both are same. So this is benzaldehyde acetate derivative. Benzaldehyde diacetate derivative. Benzaldehyde diacetate derivative. Which on acid hydrolysis yield benzaldehyde. So this is benzaldehyde. So when toluene on treatment with chromic oxide in presence of acetic anhydride, CH3CO twice O means acetic anhydride gives benzaldehyde diacetate derivative. Look at here, diacetate, CH3CO, O, diacetate derivative. So benzaldehyde diacetate derivative, which on acid hydrolysis gives benzaldehyde. So this is a second method for the preparation of aromatic aldehyde from toluene. Okay, let us see third method. Third method is side chain chlorination, what we can call side chain chlorination of toluene gives benzal, which on acid hydrolysis yield benzaldehyde. So carefully see here, guys. Third method is side chain chlorination of toluene gives benzal, which on acid hydrolysis yield benzaldehyde. So how this one is happening? So again we are taking here toluene. So toluene on treatment with side chain chlorination means H nu photon we have to add here light. So chlorination we are adding here. What is forming? Intermediate is benzal here. Benzal means CHCl2. This is a benzal. Yes. This is toluene. This benzal on acid hydrolysis yield benzaldehyde. Yield benzaldehyde. So benzene with CHO means it is benzaldehyde. Right. So toluene on side chain chlorination yield benzal. Benzal means CHCl2. Benzene with CHCl2. Which on acid hydrolysis yield benzaldehyde. Benzene with CHO is called benzaldehyde. So this is a third method for the preparation of a benzaldehyde from toluene. I hope you understood. So this is regarding from toluene is over now. Now second category. Next one, from benzene. Carefully see here, guys. We are studying preparation of aromatic aldehydes and ketones. In that, first is from toluene. From toluene, again three methods are there. First one is Itard's reaction. Second one is toluene is treated with acetic anhydride and chromic oxide, we are getting benzaldehyde acetate derivative, which on hydrolysis yield benzaldehyde. Third method is side chain chlorination of toluene yield benzal, which on acid hydrolysis yield benzaldehyde. Now we are studying second main category, from benzene. From benzene, again two sub methods are there. From benzene, if we use CO, HCl and anhydrous AlCl3 as a catalyst, that is called a Guterman-Koch reaction. And to benzene, if you add acetyl chloride and anhydrous AlCl3 as the catalyst, that is called Friedel-Crafts reaction. So that reaction we have to study now. From benzene, again first one is Guterman-Koch reaction. What is this Guterman-Koch reaction? Is benzene on treating with benzene on treatment with carbon monoxide and HCl in presence of anhydrous AlCl3 gives benzaldehyde. So this reaction is called Guterman-Koch reaction. So let us see that one. What is that? Benzene we have to take in this case. This is our benzene, which on treatment with carbon monoxide and HCl in presence of anhydrous AlCl3 as a catalyst, what we are getting? We are getting benzaldehyde. So this is a product. Benzaldehyde is a product. So this is from benzene, that is called Guterman-Koch reaction. Okay. Now we will study second method. That is nothing but from benzene. Second method is Friedel-Crafts reaction. Okay. This is very important for your examination point of view. Guterman-Koch reaction, Itard's reaction and Friedel-Crafts acylation. So in that, second one is Friedel-Crafts acylation. Friedel-Crafts acylation. Friedel-Crafts acylation. Benzene on treatment with on treatment with acetyl chloride. What is the reagent here? Acetyl chloride. Acetyl chloride in presence of anhydrous AlCl3. Anhydrous AlCl3 as a catalyst to yield, here ketone is formed, okay, to yield acetophenone. Acetophenone. So this is called as a Friedel-Crafts acylation. Benzene on treatment with acetyl chloride in presence of anhydrous AlCl3 gives acetophenone. So this is called a Friedel-Crafts acylation. Let us see that reaction. So this is benzene. This is acetyl chloride, CH3COCl, which on treatment with anhydrous AlCl3 as a catalyst. So what is getting? We are getting acetophenone. What we are getting? Acetophenone. This H and Cl. HCl is removed. This entire thing. The entire thing is bonded here. Some H is there. No. This H is went with this Cl as a HCl. Okay. This is called acetophenone. Okay. This is benzene. So this method is called Friedel-Crafts acylation. So this is clear picture regarding preparation of aromatic aldehydes and ketones. So just I will recall that one. First method is Itard's reaction from toluene. In that again three methods. First one is Itard's reaction. In Itard's reaction, toluene is treated with chromyl chloride in presence of carbon disulfide yield chromyl complex, which on acid hydrolysis yield benzaldehyde. Second method is when toluene is treated with acetic anhydride and chromic oxide, it will give benzylidine diacetate complex, which on acid hydrolysis yield benzaldehyde. Third method is side chain chlorination of toluene gives benzal, which on acid hydrolysis gives benzaldehyde. Fourth method, that is third method, means in first method three methods are over. In second category, from benzene again two methods are there. First one is Gutermann-Koch reaction, second one is Friedel-Crafts acylation. Gutermann-Koch reaction means benzene is treated with carbon monoxide and HCl in presence of anhydrous AlCl3 yield benzaldehyde. That is called Gutermann-Koch reaction. And in second one is Friedel-Crafts acylation. In that, benzene is treated with acetyl chloride, CH3COCl, in presence of anhydrous AlCl3, it will give acetophenone as a product. So this is regarding preparation of aromatic aldehydes. Now we will study some physical properties of aromatic aldehydes and ketones. So physical properties means boiling point, melting point, yes, density, solubility, these all are called physical properties. So next we are studying physical properties of aldehydes and ketones. Okay. First one is formaldehyde is HCHO means methanol or formaldehyde is gas and remaining all are liquid or solid at room temperature. Formaldehyde is a gas. Remaining all are liquid or solid at room temperature. Second one is this aldehydes or ketones having higher boiling point. These have higher boiling point than corresponding hydrocarbons. So this is due to
formation of dipole. So dipole means in carbonyl compound oxygen and carbon atoms are there. In carbon bearing partial positive charge and oxygen bearing partial negative charge. As a result, dipole is formed and molecule aggregation. So due to these two reasons, these aldehydes and ketones have a higher boiling point than corresponding hydrocarbons. And third one is lower member of aldehydes and ketones are soluble in water. This is because formation of hydrogen bond. So lower members are soluble in water. Lower members are soluble in water. This is because due to hydrogen bond formation. I hope you understood. So this is regarding all physical properties and preparation of aromatic aldehydes and ketones. If you have any doubts and queries, you can comment below. So in next coming classes, we are going to discuss chemical properties of and some chemical reactions of aldehydes and ketones. Okay, thanks for watching. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.